Greetings, people in America and all over the world. Paul Muckle here. Today is September 5th, 2013. Now, people, today's subject is going to be on the moon and whether or not NASA and the authorities have been telling us the truth about activities on the moon. Now, people, the question is, are there extraterrestrials on the moon? And have mankind seen their activities from Earth? Or are there volcanic activities going on the moon? As far as 1787, I have some information here, people, that in 1887, 226 years ago, that mankind on Earth observed activities on the moon that to them were volcanic in nature. And then in 1866, 147 years ago, mankind again observed activities on the moon that they thought were volcanic in nature. In my opinion, if it wasn't volcanic, it was extraterrestrial in nature. And here's why I said that, people. Okay, volcanic eruption on the moon. Let's hear what NASA, what the scientists have to say about volcano activities on the moon, okay? And I'm going to show you all my evidence. In a study published in the National, well, that's not important. This is what I want to show you guys here. Quote from Gizmodo, February 21st, 2013, the moon's surface like a dead planet. The last volcanic eruption occurred in the moon occurred several billion years ago. So you see that, what they're saying, people. Scientists are saying that there haven't been any volcanic eruption in the moon which occurred before several billion years ago. Okay, that's what they're saying. Okay, so now let's hear what the scientists in 1787 and 1886 have to say, because they contradict what NASA and today's present day scientists are saying. And they had several proof to back it up, people. So let me show you guys first, right? Let's go to the Linné crater on the moon, okay? God, this is very important to what I'm about to show you guys. The Linné crater. I don't know if I'm pronouncing the word right, but I'm pronouncing it my way. The Linné is a small lunar impact crater located in the western Mare Serenitatis. The mare around this feature is virtually devoid of other features of interest. The nearest named crater is Banting, to the east-southeast. The estimated age of this crater is only a few tens of millions of years. Mark this, people. Mark this word. Yes. The estimated age of this crater is only a few tens of millions of years. It was earlier believed to have a bowl shape, but data from the LRO show that it has a shape of a flattened inverted cone. The crater is surrounded by a blanket of ejected form during the original impact. This ejector has a relatively high albedo, making the feature appear bright. In 1866, the experienced lunar observer and mapmaker Johann Friedrich Julius Schmidt made the surprising claim that Linné had changed its appearance. Here, this is important because I'm about to show you guys this guy's proof. Instead of a normal, somewhat deep crater, it had become a mere white patch. A controversy arose that continued for many decades. However, this crater size tests the limit of visual perception of Earth-based telescopes. In conditions of poor seeing, this feature can appear to vanish from sight. So now, people, you hear how present-day scientists and astronomers, they're trying to discredit this guy, saying that, however, this crater size tests the limit of visual perception of Earth-based telescope. In conditions of poor seeing, this feature can appear to vanish from sight. However, people, even though NASA and all these people are discrediting Smith's claim, right, saying that poor lighting and stuff like that, if these people were the same people, they use the same mathematical calculations, okay, to discover the asteroid belt and to discover the minor planets. So, when it suit NASA's purpose to give these people credit, they give them. When it suit the purpose to discredit them, they do it. I'm going to give you all my proof now. So, Smith here claimed that the Linné crater changed appearance. Okay? It used to be huge and wide, but then it became a mere white patch. Okay, now, this is the Linné crater. This is how it looks. Okay? This is how it looks today. But according to Smith, it didn't look like that when he first observed it. Let me show you all what Smith have to say about that. Bear with me, please. Okay, people, in this book here, right? Handbook of the Stars. I'm going to use it right to prove to you guys, right, that several astronomers and stargazers witness a great phenomenon on the moon, either volcano erupting on the moon, or if the volcano did not erupt on the moon, then it was a massive extraterrestrial activities, and these people witnessed it for themselves. They were not seeing any illusions or any trick of the light. This is an actual volcanic eruption. In 1787 and 1866, if not, it was massive extraterrestrial activities. Handbook of the Stars for school and home use. By W.J. Ralph and J.A. Gillett. Teachers in a high school, Cambridge, Massachusetts, Boston, Woolworth, Ainsworth and Company, New York. Published 1868. The moon. Having now learned something of the star on which we live, let us try to become acquainted with our other stars. We will begin with the moon. Okay? So, let's skip that and go to my point. Here we see, people, this is a picture that they have of back in the 1800s, okay? They could actually see inside the craters of the moon, people. Look how perfect this picture is. So they could see a lot of what we can see with their kind of telescope back in the 1800s and the 1700s. People could actually see inside the craters of the moon clearly. Okay, NASA may have more powerful telescope today, but they have something that NASA didn't have. They have clarity. Because NASA is closer, yes, but back then, they were not so much smog in the earth, so they had a clear vision. Okay, because these people could see Venus at midday, people, at midday, 12 o'clock in the day. Venus was visible at 12 o'clock in the day, even when the sun was out. So, imagine how close everything was to these people back in the 1800s. So, anyway, the point is, they could see clearly into these craters in the moon, so they know what they saw. So let's go. Let's get to the part where I want to read to you guys. Are there active volcanoes on the moon? In 1787, Sir William Herschel announced that he had observed 3 volcanoes in a state of eruption in different parts of the moon. And modern astronomers have repeatedly noticed luminous spots in the dark portion of the lunar disk, some of which were so distinct and striking that they might readily be taken for active volcanoes. So you see, people, whatever they saw, right, was so distinct and striking that they might readily be taken for active volcanoes. The prevailing opinion among astronomers, however, is that these appearances are due to the reflection of the Earth's light from certain mountain tops, which from their nature or their position have a greater reflective power than other parts of the moon. So people, whatever they were witnessing, okay, they thought it was either a volcano erupting or lights from the Earth. They know it had nothing to do with the sun or the moon's own radiation or the craters. What they saw was distinct, and they thought it was lights from the Earth. But people, are you telling me that the light, the Earth is so bright that it casts a light on the moon that could reflect back to Earth? It's a phenomenon which they couldn't explain. But this guy thought he saw a volcanic eruption. And it's important to show you what this guy thinks, because it goes to the point I'm about to show you guys how two people cannot be wrong. Okay, so in 1887, this guy thought he saw volcano eruptions. Okay, now let's go. Recent observations, however, show that changes of some kind are still going on in the lunar craters. In October and November of 1866, Smith, the director of the observatory at Athens, noticed that the deep crater Linnae, remember the Linnae that we seen earlier, people, whose diameter is 5.6 miles, has completely disappeared. And in its place, there was only a little whitish luminous cloud. Now people, this is very important. Let's go to what they said about Linnae earlier. Okay. Remember here, right? Linnae, whose diameter is 5.6 miles, okay? That's how big Linnae is. That's how they measured it, okay? 5.6 miles. Let's see how big they have Linnae here. Okay, over here, they have Linnae, the diameter is 2.4 kilometer. Okay, that's how big NASA claim Linnae is. 2.4 kilometers, okay? Now, let's see how much is 2.4 kilometers. You got people remember, right? The scientists back in 1866 is claiming that the crater basically grew smaller or disappeared. And over here they're claiming that it's poor lighting, okay, and that it was hard for them to know the size. So which means these people are setting them up, okay? So now, Linnae here, he said 2.4 kilometers. But in my video here, it says it is 5.6 miles. Now, before Before I prove to you all the discrepancy, let us finish this first. Recent observation, however, show that changes of the some kind are still going on in lunar craters. In October and November of 1866, Smith, the director of the Observatory of Attem, noticed that the deep crater Linne, whose diameter is 5.6 miles, had completely disappeared, and in its place was only a little whitish luminous cloud. He at once called the attention of other European astronomers to the fact. So you see, people, he didn't see it by himself. He called it to the attention of other European astronomers to the fact. And in December, the locality of the lost crater was carefully examined by many of them. All agreed with Smith that Linne could not be seen at the time when it was most favorable situated for observation, and when smaller craters in its immediate neighborhood were very distinct with the shadows within them. So you see, people, not just one person seen, it wasn't just Smith alone who saw it. He called it to the attention of other European astronomers to the fact, and that the locality, many of them observed it and all agreed with Smith that Linne could not be seen at the time when it was most favorable situated for observation, even though smaller craters in its immediate neighborhood were very distinct with the shadows within them. So people could even see the shadows inside of these smaller craters that were in the immediate neighborhood of this Linne. And they could not see Linne. So what happened? Where did it disappear to? The obscuration, whatever may have been its cause, appeared to have ceased in the latter part of December. So you see, people, in December it disappeared when the crater was distinctly seen by Dr. Tiergen at Berlin. So now they could see it now. Okay, let's move down. It is said that one of Schroeter's map gives a dark spot in the place of Linne, and that the crater is not to be found on Russell's globe or maps of the same year, 1797. So now we see people, different people who made different maps. On one map, it give a dark spot, and another one, it doesn't appear at all, from which it may be inferred that the crater has previously been observed, obscured. So, there's proof, people, that the crater was really obscured. It disappeared because we have two different maps. One showing a dark spot in a place where the crater should have been, and one showing none at all. So now here's the interesting part moving down. The moon has little or no atmosphere. The latest observation upon Linne, according to Silliman's journal, July 1867, appeared to show in the center of the bright spot covering the former crater, a minute black spot. So you see, people, now, they're telling you here that the crater they saw no longer existed. It was now a little black spot, like what NASA is showing you today. The latest observation upon Linne, according to Silliman's journal, July 1867, appears to show in the center of the bright spot covering the former crater, a minute black spot indicating a crater of about 600 yards diameter. So now, people, now we see where NASA get their small 2.4 kilometer crater from, because back in 1866, the crater was, what they say, 5.6 miles. Remember that date, 5.6 miles, right? I'm going to go back to it in a minute. The crater was 5.6 miles, right? But now, right here, it's saying it's only about 600 yards in diameter. The original crater appears to have been a deep one and about 10,000 yards in diameter. So people, what the heck is going on here? Remember in 1866, this guy said his crater disappeared and in his place was a small blotch. And now, 1867, a year later, all they see now is a black spot indicating a crater of about only 600 yards. The original crater appears to have been a deep one and about 10,000 yards. So people, can you compare that? It went from 10,000 yards in diameter to only 600 yards. What happened to the original crater? I must show you all. This small crater was so plainly visible as to have been noticed. So you see people, this small crater was so plainly visible as to have been noticed independently, as it would seem, by Dr. Smith at Athens, by Father Secchi at Rome, and by Professor Lehmann at New Haven. So you see people, look at how many people, see, even the Pope, even the priest, Pope or Cardinal, whoever he was, at Rome, witnessed this. That in place of a huge crater, which was 10,000 yards in diameter, from that one appear a smaller crater, 600 yards in diameter. And it was plainly, this smaller crater was so plainly visible as to have been noticed independently, people. Independently by Dr. Smith at Athens, by Father Secchi at Rome, and by Professor Lehmann at New Haven. New Haven where? Is it America or England? I don't know. Maybe it's in America. It was detected at New Haven 3 days after the sun had risen over the horizon of Linné, and when the sun was therefore 35 degrees high upon it. These observations show that any change which has taken place is not in the nature of a development of a cloud. So you see people, whatever happened, they're telling you plain out, it could not have been because of a cloud, because they saw it when the sun, 3 days after the sun had risen over the horizon line, and when the sun was therefore 35 degrees high upon it. So they're telling you right there, it couldn't have been a cloud. But imply rather that the older crater has been filled up by an eruption from the small one now visible. So you see people, they're telling you plain out that the crater that now exists today, okay, this crater that now exists today, these observations show that any change which has taken place is not in the nature of a development of a cloud, but imply rather that the older crater has been filled up by an eruption from the small one now visible. People, they're telling you straight up that the crater today that they're showing you all is not the linear crater that they observed in 1866. Okay, that's what they're telling you guys. So let me take you out today. The linear create a controversy. Okay? Because people, it's a controversy indeed, because NASA scientists today are telling you all that this little crater here is a linear crater. Well, let me get another picture first. They're telling you all that this little thing here is a linear crater. But the scientists back then are telling you guys that no, that's not the linear crater that we know. Because today scientists are telling you a small, relatively young crater, 2.4 kilometers in diameter, 600 meters deep. Okay? That's what I'm telling you all. It is surrounded by bright ejecta material under high illumination. It appears through the telescope as a bright spot. In the literature, since the second half of the 19th century, numerous mysterious changes and disappearances of Linmei have been recorded. These are classic examples observing an error, which occur when lunar details are close to the limit of resolution of a telescope. So you see, people, these people are calling it error. Classic error, classic example of observing errors, which occur when lunar details are close to the limit of resolution of a telescope. But people, these people are telling you, NASA, y'all full of it. They're telling y'all full of it because these people observe it themselves. A Pope, Dr. Smith, and Professor Lehmann. So a Pope, a astronomer, and a professor. Three distinct people. Three different fields. And they all independently verify that really was once a crater which was 10,000 yards in diameter. They were now a little one. About 600 yards. And today, that 600 yards has grown into 2.4 kilometers. Now people, let's prove something right now, right? Let's prove something right now. Remember they said, right, that the original crater was 10,000 yards, right? 5.6 miles, right? 10,000 yards. Now, how much is a yard? Let's check this. Okay, people, let's check out the figures right here. In October and November of 1866, right, they observed the Linmei crater as deep crater with 5.6 miles in diameter, right? 5.6 mile diameter had completely disappeared, and in its place there was only a little whitish luminous cloud. Okay? Now, 5.6 miles, then as you go down, it says 10,000, let's see. He said, the original crater appears to have been a deep one and about 10,000 yards in diameter. Okay, 10,000 yards in diameter compared to 5.6 miles. Now, over here, they're giving us the crater today as being 2.4 kilometers in diameter and only 600 millimeters deep. How much is 2.4 kilometers? As compared to miles. Let's check it out. So the original crater was 5.6 miles about 10,000 yards Okay? Now, how much? And today it is 2.4 kilometers. Okay, so how much is a kilometer? How to convert kilometer into yards? Let's check it out. 1 kilometer is equal to 1,093.6132 yards, right? So how do we convert this now? Let's do this. 1 kilometer equal 0.6237.11.93 miles. Okay, so we have the original crater was 5.6 miles, or about 10,000 yards, equal to 2.4 kilometers today. 1 kilometer is equal to 1,093.6 yards. 1 kilometer is equal to 0.6 miles, right? A little bit over half a mile, right? Okay, so to get the comparison to 2.4 kilometers today, as opposed to what it was yesterday, right? Okay, 1 kilometer is equal to 1,093.6 yards, right? So if you divide 1 kilometer into 10,000 yards, you'll get about 9.14 kilometers. So 1 kilometer divided sorry 10,000 yards divided by 1 kilometer equals 9.14. So you get, if you divide 10,000 yards by 1 kilometer, you get 9.14 kilometers. Okay, so the original Lemay crater would have been 9.14 kilometers, not 2.4 like the scientists are saying today. People, that's a drastic change in size. It's like what? Over four times in size. So are you telling me that what the scientists said before, since 1857, when they first observed the eruptions, you're telling me that for 200 years, for over 100 years or so before that, that they were seeing an illusion when they seen this big crater, which say was between 10,000 yards or 5.6 miles. It was only in 1867 when they noticed that the crater got smaller. So 10,000 yards divided by 1 kilometer equals to 9.4 kilometers. Okay, now let's divide that into miles. Okay, remember, 1 kilometer equal 0.6 miles, so a little bit over a half. So if you divide 9.4 by a half, you get what? You get like maybe about 4 point something miles. So the guys back in 1866, they say it was 5.6 miles. So give or take, They could have been off by 1 mile. They just had different figures. They just seen it from different point of view. 10,000 yards. Because 10,000 yards doesn't really equal to 5.6 miles. Unless I'm doing it, the multiplication wrong. So either way, it's close. Because a kilometer is more than a mile. So if they say now that Linné is only 2.4 kilometers, and back then it should be about 9.14 kilometers, which will equal to about 4 or 5 miles, something is wrong, people. These people could not have been wrong. Okay? They're telling us that this crater completely disappeared. Smith noticed that the deep crater Linné, whose diameter is 5.6 miles, had completely disappeared, and in its place there was only a little whitish luminous cloud. Okay? And he called other people, witness it. So you're telling me in 1866, before this date, and in 1787, right? Let's do the math on this one. 1866 minus 17. Where the button? 87. Equals what? So for 79 years. You telling me, people, for 79 years of observing the moon, these people saw a huge crater which was either 10,000 yards to them or 5.6 yards to others. They observed this size. Then after 1866, it was no longer a huge crater no more. It was replaced by a smaller one. So you see, people, who's wrong? It can't be these people, okay? You know who are wrong? NASA. NASA is wrong. The astronauts today are wrong. Something went on in the moon, okay? Something happened on the moon, people. Either it was volcanic eruption, or it was extraterrestrial. Because when I say extraterrestrial, the way they're describing this crater now, it's like something flattened. If it wasn't a volcanic eruption, then something sat on the crater and flattened it. What could do that but a huge extraterrestrial ship? In my opinion, if they are saying, they have proof that there was no volcanic eruption on the moon within the last tens of millions of years or billions of years ago, if they're claiming that, then what did Smith and the Pope and the professor and all these other people saw? What did they see? So now, that's something to think about, people. These people did not see no illusion. It was not pure lighting. They saw what they saw. They saw movement. They saw action on the moon. Now, let me show you all one more thing what they've written about the moon. In this other book here, A New Manual of the Elements of Astronomy, Descriptive and Mathematical, comprising the latest discoveries and theoretical views with direction for the use of the globes and for studying the Constellation, published in 1873. Let's see what they have to say about the moon. The general physical condition of the moon's surface. You say here, no reliable indication of any active volcano had ever been obtained. Although Sir William Herschel in 1787 asserted that he had seen three lunar volcanoes in actual operation. So this guy claimed he saw it. Okay? And others haven't seen it. But what I want to show you guys is, are there people in the moon? This is what they have to say about it. Are there people in the moon? This question has often been discussed, but idly, since no positive evidence can be adduced on one side or the other. The distance of the moon is too great for us to detect any artificial structures as buildings, walls, roads, etc. If there were any, and certainly without air or water, no animals such as inhabit our own planet could exist there. But the Almighty Creator can place animals and intelligent beings in any part of the universe and accommodate them to the particular circumstances of their abode. And it would perhaps be strange if he had left even our little satellite without an intelligent witness of his infinite power and beneficence. So you see, people, so the point being, NASA today and scientists are lying to us about what's going on in the moon. Because if it's true that there have been no eruption in the moon within the past tens of millions of years, then what these people saw in 1787 and 1866 and 1867 compared to what you are seeing now is proof that something extraordinary went on the moon. If it wasn't volcanic, it was extraterrestrial, intelligent, that flattened the crater. Or maybe it was a ship. Maybe all they seen was a ship. And when the ship took off, that's when all they saw was a little crater. So, you all be the judge. You all see the evidence for yourself. Remember, NASA are deceiving, so you all can't trust what NASA is telling us today. But you all see what I've shown you all, and the witnesses who saw it independently. A pope, a professor, and an astronomer independently seen that this huge 10,000 yard or 5.6 mile crater disappeared and was replaced by a tiny one. This same tiny thing that NASA is showing us today is what it was replaced with. Okay? It went from 10,000 yards at 5.6 miles. So it went from a 10,000 yard at 5.6 miles crater to a 2.4 kilometer in diameter, 600 meter deep crater that NASA now showing us. So what happened? What happened, people? This thing was independently verified by the authorities. So, the point being that it is a controversy. And who are we going to believe? We are going to believe NASA, who are accustomed to lying to us about us being alone and they have never detected any alien life? Are we going to believe NASA? Are we going to believe these scientists who saw it with their own eyes? From 1787 until 1866, these people knew, or maybe even before, they knew how wide this crater was. Then all of a sudden, 1866, bam. So, extraterrestrial people, how we gonna believe? If we believe NASA, that there was no volcanic eruption, And what these people describe, it seems to me like within a couple of days, you tell me that within 3 months that this huge crater was filled up so quickly, and they didn't see any ash clouds. Remember, they didn't see any clouds. So it could have been a volcanic eruption because they didn't see any clouds. So what was it? I showed you all the evidence. Let your voices be heard. Let your opinion be heard. We know NASA is lying. How did a crater went from one size to about half the size within 3 months? Was it really a crater there, or was it a spaceship that took off, leaving that little crater there? Who knows? You be the judge. Let your voices be heard. One love, one heart, one destiny for all humanity. And that destiny is, we're going to find out where we came from. Because our destiny, our history is our destiny. Okay? Paul Michael here, and I'm out.